In the international land and Pike's new Polydian rite, adepts are required to accept as truth that masonry really originated with Cain. They are told that Satan, whom they name Abilis, conferred on the human race the greatest benefaction possible when he defeated God's, Adonai's, plot to keep the knowledge of sexual behavior, and the secret of procreation, from our first parents. The initiate are told that Abilis initiated Eve into the pleasures of sexual intercourse, and taught her the secret of procreation, and thus made her and Adam equal in power to God. The initiate is also told that, as the result of the sexual relationship, Eve gave birth to Cain, who started the movement, Masonry, and put the Luciferian ideology into effect here as it is in that part of the celestial world over which Lucifer reigns. Thus, where the members of the lower degrees of the Scottish Seven Rite are taught that Heron was the father of Masonry, those admitted to the highest degree are taught differently. Study of the Manichaean movement and doctrine informs us that in order to prevent God's plan to make Adam and Eve the first parents of his human race, Satan seduced Eve and possessed her, and was the father of Cain and Eve's first daughter also. The Manichaean doctrine teaches that Cain married his sister, and that the progeny of this union, incest, have perpetuated Satanism ever since. Without wishing to labor this point too heavily, it is of interest to point out that Scripture relates there was something very displeasing to God about Cain's marriage. Cain also murdered his brother Abel, and Christ in his day castigated those of the synagogue of Satan as, "Ye are sons of your father the devil, his lusts shall ye do." He is a murderer from the beginning, and abode not in the truth, because there is no truth in him. John 8:44, the serpent is the name by which Satan is known in the Holy Scriptures, Rev. 22:9. The serpent is the symbol of Satanism and secret societies which worship him as prince of the world. Scriptures refer to Eve and the seed of the serpent, General 3:1-16. Therefore we may ask, where did the seed of the serpent come from? Paul said, in 2 Cor, that Eve had been unchaste with the serpent, Lucifer, devil, Satan. Lucifer means the bright and shining one. Right here is the origin of the seed of the serpent. In General 3:15, God said, I will put enmity between thee and the woman, and between thy seed and her seed. In saying this to the serpent, Lucifer, devil, Satan, God stated that Lucifer would have a seed, just as physical as Eve's seed would be physical. In General 3:15, God said to Eve, and thy desire shall be to thy husband, which indicated plainly that her desire had previously been to another. In Cor 11:2-3, Paul here was talking about chastity, to present the Corinthians as a chaste virgin to Christ. In the very next verse, Paul said, but I fear, lest by any means, as the serpent beguiled Eve through his subtlety. Paul here affirmed that Eve did not present herself a chaste virgin to Adam. Remember, there is only one way for a virgin to lose her chastity. In General 4:1, Eve thought that Cain was her promised seed, but later acknowledged that she was mistaken and that Seth, not Cain, was her promised seed, when she said, General 4:25, for God hath appointed me another seed instead of Abel, whom Cain slew. Cain and Abel were twins, General 4:3-4, for they became of age at the same time and presented their offerings on the same day. Abel was the son of Adam, but Cain was the son of Lucifer. Lucifer and his seed have been killers down through the centuries, and Christ accused them of having slain all the prophets from Abel to his time, Matt 23:35. Lucifer begat a seed, as God said he would, 1 John 3:12. Not as Cain, who was of that wicked one. Lust is sexual desire outside the natural law of God. Therefore Christ himself seems to have confirmed that Satan was lustful and is father of the synagogue of Satan, as those who are Satanists teach and believe. Satanists have always used sex bribery and the depravities and perversions of sex to obtain control of men and women they wish to use to further the secret plans of their diabolical conspiracy. Satanism makes a god of sex. They worship the human body because of its sexual abilities. When men and women prove they are unyielding to all other forms of devilish temptation, they often fall as the result of becoming involved in illicit relationships and perversions. Did not David commit abominable sexual crimes, including incest? Then, Christ also told us that the father of the synagogue of Satan was a murderer from the beginning. Who else could that person have been but Satan? Did he not inspire Cain, his son, to kill his own brother, Abel? Has murder not been the stock in trade of those who have comprised the synagogue of Satan ever since? What is revolution and war if not murder practiced on a man? Another important fact concerning incest being used to start the synagogue of Satan on this earth is the practice of pagan kings, who worshipped the devil. In order to perpetuate their line of succession, they insisted that their sons marry their own sisters. But regardless of what is right or what is wrong, the fact remains that when Christ did start his mission, he told us that the Luciferian conspiracy had reached the stage where Satan, as prince of this world, had obtained control over all those in high places. The words in General 4:15 seem to indicate that after Adam and Eve defected from God, he willed that what has happened since should take place. He said, "Whosoever should slay Cain, vengeance shall be taken on him sevenfold." It would seem that after our first parents defected, God insisted that those who truly wish to love him and serve him voluntarily for all eternity, out of respect for his infinite perfections, should prove their sincerity. Without the adversary and the synagogue of Satan, there would be no real test. The Holy Scriptures give us enough information to enable us to decide for ourselves which way we want to go. Satanism teaches that Jesus Christ is one and the same as Saint Michael, and is the younger brother of Satan. Satanism also claims that God sent Saint Michael to earth in the form of Jesus Christ in order that he might end the Luciferian conspiracy here as he had previously done in heaven. Both Satanists and Luciferian adepts boast that Christ failed in his mission. They make the reacting of his defeat the major part in the celebration of the Black Mass. Pike revised and modernized the Black Mass and named his brainchild the Adonaicide Mass. The word Adonaicide means the death, or end, of God. The death of God was the primary purpose of NITZSCHEISM.8. It would seem that because the enmity between Satan and Saint Michael started in heaven, and because Christ, while on earth, rejected the overtures of Satan to join him in rebellion against the absolute supremacy of God, the enmity has been carried out so that Christianity has been, and still is, honeycombed with Luciferian and or satanic selves. Since Christ first picked his apostles, these agent-doers always hide their true identity while they bore industriously from within. Today they are to be found disguised as modernists, weakening the various denominations so that they will be ready to collapse when those who direct the conspiracy at the top decide it is time to provoke the final social cataclysm. Pike explained what is intended to happen in a letter he wrote to his director Mazzini of the WRM August 15, 1871. This letter is quoted elsewhere. It is catalogued in the library of the British Museum, London, England 9, and has been quoted from and referred to by dozens of authorities and students of the WRM, including Cardinal Rodriguez of Chile. See page 118 of The Mysteries of Freemasonry Unveiled, 1925. English translation, 1957. That the Luciferian conspiracy does exist, and has had unbroken continuity since its very beginning, regardless of whether we take its beginning in the celestial world, or from the Garden of Eden, proves it to be of supernatural origin and direction. Nothing conceived in a human mind could be so perfect, so diabolical, so titanic in dimensions, or so utterly destructive as the Luciferian conspiracy, which today we call the World Revolutionary Movement, WRM. Every time an attempt has been made by ecclesiastical and or civic officials to expose Satanism as the inversion of God's plans and laws, and the antithesis of the Christian religion, the adjunctor of the high priests of the Luciferian Creed, who are located behind the scenes of all governments, both secular and ecclesiastical, have so far succeeded in turning the intended exposure into an actual and factual witch hunt. To prevent real Satanists and dedicated Luciferians from being exposed and punished, the Synagogue of Satan and the High Priests of the Luciferian Creed, who control the SOS, have always succeeded in throwing an ample number of substitutes into the hands of the investigators, who provided the executioners with enough victims to satisfy the outraged feelings of the princes, both religious and secular, and the bloodlust of the angry mobs. Until recently, these substitutes were accused of being witches and or sorcerers who worshipped the devil. Believers in God will be next. Between 1486 and 1675, 32 ecclesiastical measures were taken against Satanism, and between 1532 and 1682, 149 witches and or sorcerers were burned, 78 banished from their countries, and 124 punished in other various ways. These measures and punishments affected Americans. They were accused of being Satanists and furthering the Luciferian conspiracy against Christianity. Public attention was thus kept centered upon unimportant victims, most of whom had been charged or betrayed by the high officials who kept their own identity with the Luciferian conspiracy secret. 10. The scriptures and writings of inspired men since the advent of Christ are full of incidents of demonic possession of individuals, but except in the collect, read by priests celebrating the Mass on the 17th Sunday after Pentecost, one is unable to find anything very definite on the diabolical contagious, diabolical contagion or the devil's influence on the human masses. This is rather extraordinary because if wars and revolutions are, as I maintain, the destructive force being used by those who direct the WRM to eliminate all other forms of government and religion, then the devil's influence on the goyim, human masses, is far more powerful, seductive and deceptive than is the possession of an individual. There can be no logical denial that the devil, through his earthly agentor, can and does influence the thinking of the masses in order to produce evil mass results, including wars and revolutions. We refer to the manner the secret powers of evil have of using propaganda and mass psychology to serve their diabolical purposes.